in the shine. They try to break me, try to take me out,
but I got Jesus on my side.
Felt so bad I thought I would die.
But ain't no power stronger than the one who came and laid down his life.
And I got mountains to climb, but the enemy can't stop me, cause there's a calling on my life. So when I'm crying, don't last too long, cause he gon' step in and make it alright. Won't he do it? He said he would. Fight your battles for you, they gon' wonder how you sleep at night. Won't he do it? Oh, yes he will. Anybody tell you something different, you know that's a lie. You gon' look back and be so amazed.
Good morning, ladies. Thank you guys so much for joining us today on this beautiful Saturday. With all that we have gone through over the last 18 months, isn't it a blessing to be able to come together today? And when I heard that more than 300 women, and that number is probably growing, even as we speak, have logged on to join us from all over the country, perhaps all over the world, that certainly made my heart smile. I'm Kayla Adams. I am so blessed to be your MC today. I look forward to spending the next couple of hours with you. What better way to spend a Saturday, right, with more than 300 of my favorite people, 300 beautiful, amazing ladies. It feels like a day to get the girls together, and that's what we're going to do. We're getting the girls together, but we're praising God at the same time. So let's have a good time today. And I don't know about you, but that video was absolutely beautiful to be able to go back and reflect over the first 5 years. Look at the blessings and to see where God has taken this amazing ministry from the time he planted the idea into our founding pastor's mind and vision, the late, great Dr. Reginald Doolin. I'm sure he is so proud to see just what we've done and how the church has grown and evolved. God led in all these years. It's one thing to have a vision, but to see that vision come to fruition, and even to not just see the vision, but even for it to continue to grow, because that's exactly what God's vision is supposed to do, continue to grow and manifest even beyond what the original thoughts and concepts were. So it is absolutely a blessing. I'm going to say good morning, queens. And yes, I called you a queen, because that's exactly who you are in God's eyes, and God's the way he sees you is as a queen. We know that God created us in his image, right? And he's the King of Kings, right? So if he's the King of Kings, certainly you are a queen. And with all that we've experienced over the last 18 months, we certainly want to remember when times get tough, we are indeed queens. Those are some of the things that keep us smiling in spite of everything that's going on around us. It's been a rough season, right? But guess what we know about seasons? What do? They change. So we are looking forward to coming out of this season. And I think today and the things that we'll learn today and the things that we'll get today will be one of the things that help us as we come out of this season. So we have an amazing program lined up today. I'm not going to talk your ear off just yet, maybe throughout the program. But right now, I want to share just a few housekeeping things with you. Number one, we're on Zoom, right? This amazing technology. I don't know if any of you guys used to watch the Jetsons, but it was one of my favorite cartoons growing up, right? And the thought that we could be on a video conference, remember George and Jane would talk to their people on video. Mr. Spacely would call in and yell at him, his boss, on video conference, right? We thought that seemed so far out. I know I did. I thought it seemed far out, it seemed unrealistic, but to be in this lifetime, in our lifetime, experiencing Zoom, and not even a global COVID-19 pandemic can keep us from coming together and praising God. I know we are all excited to actually have this women's conference this year because of that, and I think it makes us so grateful. But because we are on Zoom, There are a couple of things that we need to consider, right? So you have the option of keeping your camera on, or you can turn your camera off. Totally up to you. But if you keep your camera on, please be aware of your background. Believe me, I've been texting my family all morning. Don't walk behind me. Don't come in here talking. I am emceeing our women's conference. I'm talking to my friends today. So don't come in here. So we might have to tell, just text our families nicely. Hey, remember our background. Remember our cameras on. If you don't want to keep your camera on, that's great as well. I'm loving seeing your beautiful faces, but it's totally up to you. You also have the option virtual backgrounds. Well, you know, some people play with those. So it's up to you, but just be mindful of your background as well if you do have your cameras on. And if you're not speaking, we would please ask you to mute so that we can hear the person who is up speaking today. So those are just a couple of housekeeping things I wanted to share. We are going to play a fun game, and it's a hoot in a little bit. So if you can please download Kahoot It, that is the app, or you can go to the website, which is Kahoot It, Kahoot.it, excuse me. And Kahoot is spelled like it sounds, K-A-H-O-O-T, so Kahoot.it. We will share that again later as we get closer to the game, but I wanted to share that with you all now so that you have an opportunity to download it, because once we get to the game, it's going to be time. So you don't want to spend your time trying to get that. So Kahoot, not it. All righty. So one person, I think if you can mute, because we can hear somebody talking. And you guys, I don't want you to stress about, you know, these things either, because today is stress-free, right? So we're going to have fun. It is technology. Things happen, but we're not going to let that put a damper, you know, on our program today at all. So those are the things that I wanted to share right now. I will be sharing more later, but we would love to go ahead and kind of move forward in the program. And with that being said, we're going to ask, see, I'm rolling this up, Sister Gwen Fisher to come and give us her an opening prayer.
Let's bow as we pray. Eternal God, all powerful and merciful, your word is a torch for our path and a light for our way. Open our eyes, O Lord, and enlighten our spirit that we may understand your revelation in all its purity and holiness. Bless our conference. Bless all in attendance, dear Lord. May what's presented today inspire, transform lives, and make us worthy to bear your image, Father. As we live into your promises, Heavenly Father, help us to help each other, for we truly need each other. Father God, we're grateful for all who've gathered today, and we're grateful for those who prepared this conference. Rouse our spirits, Lord Jesus, that whenever you come to the door and knock, you may find us aware, awake, ready to serve you. May we, your servants, live by faith, walk in hope, and be renewed in love through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
Amen. Thank you so much. That was absolutely beautiful, Sister Fisher. And now we got to go through the first 5 years. We're going to see another video that's going to take us on that next 5 years from 2006 to 2010. Take a look with us back down memory lane.
Sometimes sorrow is the door to peace. Sometimes heartache is the gift I need. You're faithful, faithful in all things. To me.
I love that. A decade of divine deliverance. What a wonderful theme for 10 years. And now here we are celebrating 20 years. What a blessing. What an absolute blessing. So ladies, now it's time to have a little fun. Remember I told you in the beginning that we were going to play a game. Hopefully you've already downloaded Kahoot.it, K-A-H-O-O-T.it. Just a little housekeeping before we start the game. Please make sure you put your first and last name when you sign into it. It'll walk you through it, but put your first and last name because we want to know exactly which Kayla it is who wins, or which Angela it is who wins, or whoever it is that wins. We want to be able to identify you, and putting your last name will help us to identify you. If you have a common name, you might even want to put your middle initial, totally up to you, but we certainly would love you to put your first and last name because we want to be able to clearly identify you when you win. So without further ado, I'd like to introduce Sister Shatrina Forte, who's going to help us break a little ice. Sister Forte.
Good morning, ladies. I am so happy that you guys have joined us today, and we wanted to do a little something fun, and so we're going to play
a game. Sister Forte is muted, so while she's unmuting, please make sure you guys are bringing Kahoot up, because you don't want to waste your 5 minutes trying to download the app or bring it up. Sister Forte?
Can you hear me now? Are you able to hear
me? We can hear you.
We still cannot hear you, Sister Forte.
Okay,
I can hear her.
She's clear.
I can hear.
She's clear.
We hear you, Trina. We hear you.
Okay. All right. So I'm going
to go to Kahoot.it.
I think they can hear me. I don't know. Okay.
We hear you.
Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and get started. We bring up our screen. All right, hold on 1 second, ladies.
Sister Forte, I can't hear you. I'm trying to see if everybody, yeah.
Okay, yes, they can hear me.
Y'all can, okay.
Yes, okay, yes. So we'll bring up our screen for Kahoot. All right, so you guys should see a screen that says Icebreaker CPC Trivial 1. Our next screen. We're going to go over a little bit of the housekeeping so you guys will know how to play it. So we'll have 5 minutes to complete this Kahoot. You're supposed to go to Kahoot.it. And this is the pin. I'm going to put the pin in the chat, and the pin will also remain on the screen as we are playing the game, just to make sure that everybody has a chance to get in. And like Sister Kayla said, we please need your first and last name, because I want to be sure which Rebecca is going to win the prize or which April is going to win the prize. So please be sure to use your first and last name. And if you have a common name, go ahead and put your initial in the middle of that, your middle initial in there, so we'll know exactly who it is. We have 5 questions, and you have to answer all 5 questions. And the winner will be announced at the end of each game, and I'll also review the answers to the questions. So this is just a fun game, just to kind of get us in the mood for being a part of our conference. So our next screen. All right, so remember, Kahoot.it, and the pin is 0476797. All righty. And remember to put your first and your last name, because that is going to be important. And if you'll go ahead and start the timer, we'll begin.
Can you put that in the chat?
Yes, ma'am. I'm going to put it in the chat. You can go ahead and begin the timer.
Yeah.
and enough headache. I've had so many ups and downs. Don't know how much more I can take. See, I've decided that I cried my last tear.
I let it go
yesterday. Now either I'm gonna trust you, or I may as well walk away. Stressing don't make it better.
Don't make it better.
Nah, nah. Don't make it better. No, no way. See, I've decided that I cried my last tear yesterday.
Ayanna Cook, Shirley Peace, and Angela R. Brown. So if you ladies will direct message me your email address, I will get your prizes out to you. Now, let's go back to review what our answers to our questions were for those people who may not have gotten all five questions. So our first question was, what African-American female nearly won the 2018 gubernatorial race in Georgia. And of course, that was Stacey Abrams. All right. Our second question, which woman in the Bible was in her feelings because her sister was nowhere to help during Jesus's visit. And of course, that was Martha. Our third question, which person below has not been a speaker at our women's conference? And of course, that's Oprah Winfrey. We are looking forward to her coming to one of our conferences in the future, but she hasn't been one just yet. Number four, the eloquent preaching pastor of Central Point Church of Christ is Dr. Rodney Doolin. So that was a true or false question. So everyone should have gotten that one right. And our last question, when a mother says this, and now hold on, let me open up this entire question so I can say all of it. When a mother says, I'm not one of your little friends, is she saying you're being disrespectful? You need to watch your tone, or you about to get it? And of course, that answer is all of the above. Thank you, ladies, for playing. And again, if those winners, Ayana Cook, Shirley Peace, and Angela R. Brown will direct message me your email address, I will make sure you ladies get your prizes. Thanks for playing.
Yay, thank you so much, Sister Forte. Listen, let me tell you ladies something. I know one thing for sure is that y'all have my back, okay? I couldn't hear, I'm like, what's going on? But y'all were letting me know what was going on. So I appreciate it so much. And it is wonderful to know that you guys are going to let me know what's going on, because having a sister who has your back and having a lot of sisters who have your back is just absolutely wonderful. So I hope you guys enjoyed that. I had not played Kahoot except maybe once before, and I didn't realize that it was so much fun, and it was fun, so much fun. Congratulations to our winners. And certainly I know we all got the question right about, not being one of your little friends, because I've said it to my daughter, and I certainly heard it growing up. So so wonderful. Thank you, ladies. Now we are going to move into hearing from our esteemed speaker. This woman needs no introduction because we all know her. She is absolutely amazing. I am going to read what it says on here about her, but I just have to say that Sister Jacqueline Doolin is an absolute blessing to the body of Christ. She is one of the most radiant people you'll ever meet, one of the most loving people you'll ever meet. She's one of the people that you love to see on Sunday morning or any days that you come into the church, because she just greets you openly and warmly and makes you feel loved and accepted. And those are the things that I love about Sister Doolin, just a few of the things, because there's so many amazing things about her. But I'm going to read a little bit more about her before she comes and shares with us. First of all, she's our founding First Lady. Sister Jacqueline Doolin was raised, she's resided in the Dallas Metroplex for more than 49 years. She's a native of Longview, Texas, and she holds a Bachelor of Science degree in biology and psychology, a Master of Education degree in secondary and higher education, and is a certified administrator. She has been happily, did y'all see that word, happily retired from the Dallas Independent School District as an Executive Director of Administrative Professional Development since 2005. Her educational career spans 30 years serving as a teacher, campus administrator, and central office administrator. She's done it all in education. Currently, Sister Jackie lends her services and talents in many areas. She's a part of the coordinating team for the Woman to Woman Ministry at Central Point Church of Christ. She also serves on the advisory committee for the National Ministers Wives Conference for the Churches of Christ. She has spoken for Ladies Day programs and coordinated workshops throughout the country. Sister Jackie recognizes that we have been blessed so that we might be a blessing to others. And she certainly is a blessing to many, many others. She considers it a privilege and an honor to have the opportunity to serve God's children, both locally and nationally. She delights in encouraging women to develop a more intimate relationship with Christ and to advance the kingdom of God through their own service. Sister Jackie was married to the late Reginald Doolin for 34 years. She is the most proud of her son, our esteemed Dr. Rodney Doolin, who serves as senior minister of the Central Point Church of Christ. Sister Jackie is blessed to have two amazing grandkids, Mia and Roman. She's an avid movie buff Jackie's alternative career would be a movie reviewer, a la Ebert, Roper, and Doolin. Sounds like fun. Sister Jackie's desire for her life is to live, to love, to learn, and to leave a legacy that positively impacts the Lord's church. That she is indeed doing. She often meditates on Romans 8 and 37, acknowledging that instead of allowing God's challenges to separate us from Christ's love, we become more than conquerors as we learn to depend even more on God. Ladies, without further ado, I know we can't stand up. We might be able to stand up, but we're just going to applause. Let's join me in a round of applause as we bring Sister Jackie Doolin to the stage, to the virtual stage. Sister Doolin.
Good morning, ladies. Here we are, our 20th annual Women's Conference. A true virtual is a first for us, but that notwithstanding, this is our 20th. That means that God has allowed us to worship together and to forge a bond as a family for now over 20 years, which in and of itself is such an amazing blessing. And you know what? I'm thankful for the blessings of being able to experience 20 years of growth, 20 years of life-altering challenges, 20 years of effective kingdom work. And he's allowed us to go through all that we've experienced to get us to this point. So we can't help but to thank him for his faithfulness and to praise him. Now, I certainly can't start this morning without acknowledging my daughter and our first lady. I simply want her to know how very proud I am of her and how she has confidently stepped into her destiny. She wears it well, and I love her for it. I thank our planning team for doing a superb job with the always Herculean task of orchestrating our conferences each year. I tell you guys all the time that we're extremely blessed here at the Point because of our many amazingly talented and gifted people. Listen, it has been exciting for me to be able to look back over our 20-year journey. And you guys should certainly take a victory lap because it would not have been possible without each of you. You know, my husband was an incredible visionary, and he dreamed of establishing a congregation where our members would feel empowered to use their many gifts and talents. And I'm just thrilled that we've continued that commitment to invest and rely on the members here at the Point. When we first embarked on this journey, we had so many different emotions. And if I can be a little transparent here, our emotions were all over the place. First of all, we were thankful. We were thankful to God for the enormous privilege of being able to lead his people. We were prayerful that he would guide us through what was then uncharted territory. We were excited about all the possibilities that we could envision being able to put in place. We were fearful of the unknown and the many pitfalls that we could possibly face. And we were concerned. We were concerned about uprooting families and moving them in a different direction. But the possibilities outweighed the fears. And with God at the helm, we embarked on a new venture. Then God did what only God can do. And when God fulfills a dream, we don't always know when or even how that dream will be fulfilled. And it may not always be fulfilled through us. Our growth has been phenomenal. And let me just put a little disclaimer here, because admittedly, I'm a bit biased. Because I believe that we have one of the most amazing spiritual leaders this side of heaven. He is skilled, he's capable, he's organized, he's impactful, he's approachable. I know, I need to stop, right? But just know that we're blessed. And I, for one, am so thankful to God for blessing us to fulfill a dream. Speaking of dreams, the poet Langston Hughes asked the question, what happens to a dream deferred? Does it dry up like a raisin in the sun? Yet we know that dreams are but an extension of our lives. A dream is an intrusion of the supernatural upon the subconsciousness of man. In Genesis 37, you remember Joseph had a dream. He was 17 years old, and his dream so angered his brothers that just as soon as they got a chance, they plotted to get rid of him and his coat of many colors. Now, ladies, it's one thing to be jealous, but envy takes it to a whole different level. Jealousy is that emotion when you fear you may be replaced in the affection of someone that you love or desire. In this case, for the brothers, it was Joseph's relationship with their dad, Jacob. But envy is that emotion when you want a possession someone else has, like that colorful coat. Joseph's story gives us a glimpse into why things happen in our lives, and also why things may not always happen when we think that they should happen. So Joseph has a dream, but makes the mistake of telling them about his dreams. Now, even though the dream was prophetic, it only served to further alienate his brothers. Joseph was not Jacob's oldest son, but he was the oldest of Rachel's two sons, and Rachel was Jacob's favorite wife. There is so much that we can glean from this story because it helps us to understand some of the dynamics that can occur in our lives. And it's a perfect story for us to look at as we look back over our 20-year Central Point journey. Follow with me this morning as we look at the course of events that landed Joseph into Egypt and why his dream had to be deferred. Their dad sends Joseph to check on his brothers. They're all feeding the flock. On his way, Joseph sees this man and asks if he's seen his brothers. The man tells him that they went to Dothan. The brothers look up and see him coming. See, they were able to spot him because of that colorful coat. The brothers say, the dream is coming. And I'm sure they probably said it with a little sarcasm. So they plot to kill him, cast him into a pit, and then say that a wild beast devoured him. And I'm sure feeling good about this little plot that they just devised, they said, now we'll see what becomes of his dreams. Then Reuben, who was Leah's son and the oldest of all of the brothers, develops a conscience. And he says, no, let's not kill him. Let's not shed blood. Let's just cast him into this pit out in the wilderness. See, Reuben's plan was to return to rescue him because he knew, being the oldest, that he would be the one to blame. So they take his coat that they were so envious of and cast him into an empty pit. And after they finished their little evil deed, they sat down to eat. And as they were doing that, they noticed a group of Ishmaelites coming toward him. The Ishmaelites were on their way to Egypt to sell their goods. Then Judah, Leah's youngest son, says, hey, y'all, it would be more profitable for us to just sell Joseph than to kill him and conceal his blood. I guess Judah's consciousness kicks in as well, because he says, he's our brother and our blood. Let's just sell him to the Ishmaelites. So they pull him up out of the pit and sell him as if he were just a common slave. The Ishmaelites buy Joseph, take him to Egypt, and sell him to Potiphar. Now, Potiphar was one of Pharaoh's officers. See, Joseph could not see down the road to understand why God is allowing all of this to happen to him. Just as for us, when we got started, we were not able to see Central Point as we are now in 2021. Remember Langston's poem, What Happens to a Dream Deferred? Ladies, the things that happen in our lives are not isolated, disconnected occurrences. No. They fulfill a purpose. Joseph is now in Egypt where God needed him to be. So that was nothing but providence. When stuff happens to us and we can't understand it, it's because we can't see the bigger picture. When our lives fall apart, God needed for our lives to fall apart so that he could fulfill his purpose for us. Ladies, even though we might be in a place that we're not comfortable with at the time, trust God and know that he is the master door opener. When we decide that we're going to live for God, he will send blessings our way, blessings that we don't even know are coming. God says, just live for me. Just try me and see when I open doors you could not even imagine. See, Joseph was faithful in a foreign place. His home was Canaan, but when the Ishmaelites bought him, they sold him to Potiphar, who was in Egypt. Oh, hear this, ladies. Egypt was where God needed Joseph. He had purpose for him there. Now, fast forward to 13 years later, God sees Joseph's faithfulness and blesses him for honoring him. And during those years, Potiphar was able to see that God was with Joseph as well, and that God favored him. So he made him overseer of his house and put all that he had under Joseph's authority. Now, Sister Potiphar was another story. when she saw this young, good-looking man, she tried to seduce him. She said, lie with me. Now, this was not the first time, but this time he was in the house by himself. So she caught him by himself. And at this point, Joseph's thinking, okay, this is not going to turn out good for me. See, this is not only another man's wife. This is his master's wife. So Joseph decided that my best bet is to run. And in the process of running, he left his garment behind. Ladies, hear me. It is nothing wrong with running. When you find yourself in a situation you can't see a way out, run. Sometimes through no fault of our own, things can just happen. And you know what? There will always be stuff out there that we'll have to deal with. And it has a name. It's called life. And how well we've learned to deal with life's challenges is determined by the relationship that we've built with God. There is a direct correlation there. So Sister Potiphar is now a scorned woman. She goes to her husband and she tells lies on Joseph and even shows him his garment that he left behind. Potiphar becomes angry and had him put in prison. But the prison where he placed him was where the king's prisoners were confined. Y'all miss all these little pieces here. This is God's hand at work. Potiphar was a powerful man in Egypt, so he was able to place him in the king's prison. Remember, he was one of Pharaoh's officers. While Joseph was in the king's prison, he found favor with the keeper of the prison. So God is still working here. Then the king's butler and the king's baker offended the king. So they were put in the same prison where Joseph was placed. And while they were there, both of them had dreams that they could not understand. Now I want you to look at the sequence of events that's placed Joseph here in Egypt. His dad sends him to look for his brothers. The brothers put him in the pit. They take him out of the pit and sell him. He was sold to Potiphar, finds favor with Potiphar. He puts him over all his house. Potiphar's wife gets the hots for him. He gets put in prison and interprets dreams while there. All of these are pieces to the puzzle of his deferred dream. He was able to tell the butler the good news about his dream, but he was clear to let him know that interpretations of dreams can only belong to God. Joseph simply asked him to remember him when he got back to the king's palace. Now, hearing what he had told the butler, the baker got excited at his news and wanted Joseph to interpret his dream. But the baker's dream had a different outcome because his dream meant that he was going to die. Now, once the butler was able to get out of prison, he did not remember Joseph as he had promised. And it was not until 2 years later when Pharaoh started having some troubling dreams of his own and none of his magicians could interpret them. Did the butler remember that Joseph had interpreted his dreams while he was back in prison? Y'all seeing all these little pieces unfolding? Pharaoh sent to have Joseph taken out of prison. Joseph interprets Pharaoh's dreams and was clear to tell him, just as he has told, the butler, that it was not of him, but of God. Pharaoh then rewards Joseph by putting him over everything. Joseph is now second in command in Egypt, in all of Egypt. The only one higher in the land was Pharaoh, who was the king. The king gives him a wife. She bears him two sons, Manasseh and Ephraim. And all of this time, God has been getting Joseph ready. Now, our journeys are designed to prepare us for something greater. So understand that our 20-year growth, as difficult as it has been at times, was preparing us for where we are now. All that happened to Joseph was positioning him for where God needed him to be. Yeah, God could have blessed him while he was 17 years old and back in Canaan with his family, but Joseph was not ready then. He was too immature and not able to see beyond the bowing down part to him. Sometimes God has to get us ready for what he has in store for us. Some of the stuff that's waiting on us, we're not ready for yet. We would not be able to handle it right then. We need to go through some stuff. We need to develop some compassion. We need to experience some disappointments. We need to know what it feels like to have a heart broken. There's still some growing that we need to do. See, Joseph wasn't ready back in Canaan at age 17. Now Here he is, he's over 30 years old, and he's seeing how serving God has paid off. At 30 something, Joseph's been able to put some stuff behind him. And I'm sure there were times when Joseph said, maybe I misinterpreted my dreams. I've been through so much, maybe I didn't see what I thought I saw. I had that dream a long time ago. And look at all that I've been through. Maybe it was just a dream. With all of Joseph's hardships, God only gave him pieces of how his life would play out. All of his toils and the stuff that happened to him in his father's house, his brother's jealousy, his brother's throwing him into the pit and selling him into slavery, being tossed into prison. Had he been given all of those pieces at one time, when he first had his dream, it would have messed him up. Listen, had God shown you and me ahead of time, back 20 years ago, all that's happened in our lives, it would probably have been a totally different outcome. Some of us would still be high. I'm certainly glad that God didn't give me everything at once, or even all while it was all happening. He gave me bits and pieces when he knew that I was ready and he knew that I could handle it. He gives it to us, ladies, in bite-sized chunks when we're able to handle it. See, had we known ahead of time some of the stuff that we've been through throughout our lives, we likely would have done something different. And that something different would not have prepared us for what God had in store for us. Had Joseph known all that was about to happen to him after his dream, I'm sure he would have done some things differently. First of all, I know he would not have said, hey, y'all, one day all of y'all are going to be bowing down to me. See, some stuff we don't need to tell folk. Just let it play out. God keeps some stuff until we're ready. See, at 17, all Joseph got out of that dream was the bowing down part. At 17, Joseph would not have been able to handle those hidden facts. But now he's over 30 years old, and that dream that he saw actually involved him helping those who are now bowing before him in Egypt. When you study Joseph's dream, God actually was preparing Joseph to help those who will eventually bow down to him. See, when the famine hit, it hit everywhere. So God was sending Joseph on ahead so that he could be in a position to help his children when the famine hit Canaan. See, Joseph's dream had to be deferred until he got Joseph ready, and the need was imminent. Before he could help, God had to fix the helper. He's showing Joseph, he's sending him through some stuff, but he's using what he's going through to fix him so that he'll be able to help. Because right now, at 17, baby, had he gotten all of that stuff right now, no one would be able to stand it. When we're young and we see things happening to folk, we don't always get it. But one of my favorite pearls is, baby, just keep saying good morning. So before he can give us what he has in store for us, he needs to prepare us. When you've gone through enough stuff, you can help. You can't help but to gain compassion. You lose enough loved ones, you'll be empathetic when others lose theirs. You're able to shed tears when someone's heart is breaking. And you can offer a shoulder when the news of the doctor's bleak. Some of us listening to me right now, he's having to fix us. And I know it hurts. I know it's causing some sleepless nights. I know you don't know how it's going to turn out. I know you're thinking, Lord, what next? But just hold on. Don't give up. Don't give out. And don't give in. Because they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. So you're not going to get to the not fainting part if you don't wait on the Lord. You got to wait. Then your strength gets renewed. And with renewed strength, oh baby, you can mount up with wings as eagles. Because I promise you, it's going to take mounted wings to be able to run and not get weary, and to walk and not faint. Wait upon the Lord. He's the only one who can work stuff out for us. Remain faithful in spite of what's going on around us. Just as with Joseph, God rewards our faithfulness. He's just fixing us, making us ready for what he has in store for us. He's just simply deferring our dreams. Because Genesis 41, Joseph was at the point where he's thinking it was just a dream. He's thinking that what he received in Genesis 37 was not going to come to pass. But at the time, what he did not understand was that God had not revealed it all to him. See, in 37, all he could see was the bow down part. Now in chapter 41, Joseph is at the point where he's forgotten some stuff. It no longer mattered to him that his brothers beat him. It doesn't matter to him that they threw him in the pit. It does not even matter to him that they sold him into slavery. All he sees now is that here are my brothers and they need help. And I'm now in a position to help them. He's not concerned about getting even with them. He only wanted to know two things. Is our father still living? And where is my brother Benjamin? See, Benjamin was the only other brother that he had that was his whole brother by their mother, Rachel. God desires for us to forget some stuff. And forgetting is not that you don't remember. Remember it. Forgetting is that you've gotten past it. Yeah, they did it wrong. And the longer we hold on to stuff, the more toxic it becomes and the more miserable we become. Forgiveness is just for us, not them. We forgive so that we can move forward. It's not until we've forgotten about the hardships and when you've forgotten about how they treated you or what they said about you, and you're able to recognize how your faith has grown, that God can say, it's now time. Listen, the dream never died. It was just deferred. What God has for us, he has for us. And let me tell you about looking back. Life must be lived forward and understood backwards. Who we are has shaped who our lives has become. And who we are has been shaped also by our own life's experiences. It's that totality of those experiences that's created who we are. Listen, God grows us up through difficulties. I have never been able to look back and see growth through my good times. It's been those difficult times and those rough patches that grew me up. And I tell you what, I don't live with regrets either, because my life experiences has shaped me into who I am. And regrets would only negate who I've become. And while we're here, here's another pearl. Don't spend unnecessary time looking back over the things that you did not get accomplished or missed opportunities. Baby, we've got to come to terms with the road not taken. There may have been good reasons why it wasn't taken. Obviously, it was not in God's plan. So God steered us in another direction. Think about it. Just take one piece of that puzzle from Joseph's life. What if Joseph had not been sold to Potiphar? Look at where Joseph is now. He is in the second highest position in the land. He's there because he interpreted the king's dream. Pharaoh's dream involves 7 years of plenty and 7 years of famine. God was getting Joseph ready. So when the famine finally hits, Joseph is ready. When God sees that we're in a place where he's been trying to get us all along, he says, it's time now. They can handle it now. You know what? I used to wonder, why am I getting all of this stuff now? Why can I see it before? It's because God was not ready for me to see it then. Because had I been able to see it then, the outcome probably would have been different. Remember, after the 7 years and the famine hit, it didn't just hit Egypt. It hit all of the lands. So you do understand that it also happened in Canaan, which meant Joseph's family back home were starving, just as everyone else was starving. See, God set this thing up. The only place that where there was food was in Egypt. And he has Joseph in Egypt so that he can be in a position to prepare for the famine and be in a position where he can help his family. So Jacob sends his sons to Egypt in search of food. They don't know that this brother that they put in the pit and sold into slavery is now in control of Egypt. And when they get there, who do you think they had to bow down to? Lord have mercy. But the difference now is that Joseph has been through enough stuff that he's not seeing this as, I told y'all, you're going to bow down to me. He has a different perspective now. What he had in his heart before, God has removed. Joseph knew who they were, but they did not know who he was. And in spite of everything, he blesses them with food. And yeah, there was all that back and forth about getting Benjamin there, but still, he blesses them. See, if you need to know if you've grown spiritually, if you really want to see how you are with your walk with God, just check out how you treat folk. People that you know what they've done or what they've said, check out how you treat them. Check out how you treat folk you who mistreated you and lied on you, the backstabbers, the haters. It's when you can see yourself still being kind to them, still trying to help them. That's when you know, and God knows, that your level of faith has grown. The very ones who hurt Joseph and tried to destroy his life are now having to come to him for help. Talk about making your enemies your footstool. And when you can help, and there's not all that vindictiveness in your heart, you're where God's been trying to get you all along. God wants us to change our focus. He wants us to take our mind off of other people. Forget about our failures. Even forget about our accomplishments. Just focus on his faithfulness. And that can only happen when our faith has grown and our prayer life is strong. When we know that prayer works, the writer says prayer doesn't need proof. It needs practice. Why was his dream deferred? It was deferred so that God could get him to a point where he could fulfill his purpose. Ladies, I hope that you know that God has a purpose for your life. But in order to realize it, we have to stay connected to him. And remember, the things that happen in our lives are not isolated, disconnected occurrences. And live your life so that it impacts others. Who was it that said that you can't do conversation what you intend to do? What does your life say about you? I tell us all the time, when we look behind us, someone needs to be standing there. Leave intellectual breadcrumbs, because in addition to all of the other stuff that we owe God sustainability. I encourage us to always reach back and encourage someone else. Ask ourselves, what are we doing about preparing future generations? Have we ensured sustainability? Central point, God didn't forget about us during those early years. We were just deferred. And as we honor the past, let's be sure to embrace the present and look forward to the future. God bless you.
I'm clapping. Amen.
Because
I feel like I can hear the applause go off. I know that y'all are standing, clapping. I know y'all shouting. You know, all of those things that we couldn't hear, but Lord, we felt it. We felt it in the spirit. I have just a page of notes. Sister Doolin, thank you. I mean, just an absolute blessing. Strength during the struggle. I mean, a few things that resonated with me, all of it, but a few things that I think are great takeaways is when she talked about the possibilities outweigh the fears. You guys, as we step into things, we have to realize that as we walk into God's destiny, we're going to be scared when we embark on our dreams, but the possibilities outweigh the fears. And we have to remember that so, so much. And of course, we know that a dream deferred is not a dream denied. But let me tell you, when Sister Doolin said life must be lived forward and understood backward, oh my goodness, you talk about a shouting moment, a tweeting moment, a posting moment. Y'all, I have never heard that. I don't know about you. I've never heard it. But let me tell you, I certainly understand it. That is the absolute truth. When we look back, we understand things and we understood why we had to go through it and why God did it, so we could be more relatable, so we could see out his purpose in our lives, not our purpose. And what does your life say about you? That is true. What does your life say about you? And what are you leaving? What is that legacy? As they say, Sister Doolin, you did that. Okay. Oh my goodness. I can't say enough how blessed I feel, how blessed all these women feel, and not just us, but guess what we do when we get beautiful lessons like that? We go tell other people. So now you've equipped us with the things to go and tell other people, to bring other people to Christ. I mean, I can't say thank you enough. Ladies, please, again, just join me. Thank you, Sister Doolin. Thank you. Whew. All righty, so we looked at the first 10 years of this great church, Central Point. Now we get an opportunity to go into the second decade. We will get to see 2011 through 2015.
You healed even when I didn't know that I needed it. You rescued me, saved me. That's the power when you're near.
Where
all you heal the broken hearted, bind the wounds. Say, draw nigh to Him. Let Him in. Draw nigh to Him. Let Him in. Heal, even when I didn't know that I needed it. You rescued me.
Absolutely beautiful. Absolutely beautiful. Such a beautiful reflection. I always love when we wear our fatigues. I love our days in red and so much. I love our time together and our camaraderie together and our Ladies Day programs. And like I said, it's just beautiful. And it's beautiful to reflect on where we've been as we march forward to where we're going. So thank you guys. That was absolutely beautiful. Okay, next, ladies, we're going to have a little fun. It's our second icebreaker. Going to see who wins this time. Turn it over to Sister Forte so we can cahoot it again.
All right, ladies, I know now that you guys know how to play this game and you know how to get on to cahoot it and you know how to put your pen in. So we're going to go over that slides just one more time. All right, so this is our second icebreaker. And we're going to go to kahoot.it. We're going to add this pin, 0325-6212. Add your first and last name. Answer all five questions. I'll tell the answers at the end of each game. Next slide. We're going to go ahead and get started right now.
Oh, know how much more I can take. See, I've decided that I cried my last tear.
I let it go
yesterday.
For playing, we have three top winners: Linda K. Anderson, Latanya Brown, and Sister Shay Kathy. So if you three will direct message me in the chat, I'll make sure that you guys get your prizes. All right, so now to go over our question. Our first question was, who was Moses' sister that intervened to offer her mother as Moses' wet nurse? Of course, that was Miriam. I am sick and tired of being sick and tired is a famous quote by which civil rights activist? Fannie Lou Hamer. Identify the famous daughter-in-law, mother-in-law duo in the Bible who stayed together during trials. Of course, that is Ruth and Naomi. What was the previous use of our present Central Point building? It was a movie theater. And our last question, The Hill We Climb is a famous poem delivered at President Biden's inauguration by which up-and-coming young American? And of course, that's Amanda Gorman. Thank you guys for playing.
Yes, thank you again, Sister Forte. Let me tell you, icebreakers are never easy. Like, people think it's easy to come up with icebreakers. They're not that easy in person, and certainly coming up with fun ones virtually. But you did an amazing job, Sister Forte. I loved playing Kahootas, so thank you so much. And we got to have fun, and we got to learn. So we just appreciate it so much. Now we're going to have Sister LaShawn Hayes, who's going to come forth and give us a scripture reading.
Okay, ladies, so we've had a lot of fun. We've heard a word from Sister Doolin. Now it's time for us to open up our Bibles or our apps and meditate on the Word of God for just a moment. So if you will meet me and share with me at 1 Peter 5 and 10. I'm going to give everyone an opportunity to get there, whether it's via your physical Bible or your app. And that, once again, is 1 Peter 5 and 10. But may the God of all grace, who called us to his eternal glory by Christ Jesus, after you have suffered a while, perfect, establish, strengthen, and settle you. And Lord, we ask that may the reading and hearing of your word resonate in our spirits and resound in our life every day. Thank you for sharing the scripture with me, ladies.
Amen. Thank you so much, Sister Hayes. So now, ladies, we're going to get to have a little fun with our breakout sessions. We have just been blessed, and we have three ladies coming to share with us and bless us even further. Before we get started, and before I introduce them, I do want to just say that you know about the breakout rooms. You will be automatically assigned to a breakout room. If for some reason you need anything technical, hit us in the chat and let us know, but you should go automatically into the breakout room. When the session is over, it'll bring you automatically back to the main session. So again, we're going to have some fun as we go into these breakout sessions and learn. So I'm going to go ahead and introduce our speakers. The first speaker that I'll introduce is Nefertiria Johnson. Sister Nefertiria Johnson was born and raised in Fort Worth, Texas, and has been a member of Central Point Church of Christ since 2008. She was baptized into Christ at the age of 13 and still continues to pursue her passion and love for Christ. She graduated from Trimble Tech High School and attended TCU. Sister Nefertiria currently works as a loan processor and is active in the Breaking Free Ministry at Central Point. Sister Nefertiria and her husband, Michael, have been married for 21 years. They are a blended family with a combined total of 5 children. In her spare time, she loves spending time with family, studying God's word, and reading. Her favorite Bible verse is Isaiah 40 and 31. But they that wait for Jehovah shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. Sister Nefertiria Johnson. Our next breakout speaker is Sister Linda Murray. Sister Linda Murray is a native of Los Angeles, California, where she served with her late husband, James K. Murray, for 26 years. Sister Linda is happily retired from the Department of Justice, FBI, and currently resides in Dallas, Texas, where she attends the Central Point Church of Christ Mesquite campus. Sister Linda holds a bachelor's degree in psychology and enjoys working with women throughout the body of Christ. Sister Linda has 3 adult children, which she is very proud of. Sister Linda's favorite Bible verse is Romans 8 and 35 through 39. Sister Linda Murray. And our last breakout speaker is Sister Denise Simmons, our very own songbird. Sister Denise Simmons is a native of Dallas, Texas. She attended Dallas West Church of Christ from an early age. Sister Denise and her family have been members of Central Point Church since 2000, since inception. She is the wife of Shepherd Anthony Simmons. They have been married for 25 years. Sister Simmons is a mother, a Gigi, and a new mother in love. Sister Denise is active in many ministries, including our music ministry, women's ministry, and benevolence ministry, to name a few. Sister Denise also teaches Awana Children's Bible class and facilitates various ladies' classes. She has been employed with J.P. Morgan for 16 years. As I said, she's our songbird and singing is her passion. Her favorite quote is, "Lead with your life." Sister Denise Simmons, ladies, help us welcome all three of our breakout speakers. Yes. And now you will be taken into your breakout session. Have an amazing time. And I look forward to coming back together with you guys soon. Oh my goodness. Ladies, I see everybody still coming back into the main room. My hands are still up from the last breakout room I was in. My goodness, these breakout rooms were on fire. So I was blessed to be able to pop in and out since I'm the MC to see what was going on in the rooms. I felt like I was in Wakanda, y'all. I was like popping in and popping out. But let me tell you, even though I was popping in and popping out, those nuggets were dropping. I couldn't even write fast enough. I mean, just some amazing, amazing content. And one of the things that really blessed me is that there were a few of the rooms, I could see that there were a couple of more than one woman in the room together. There were rooms where there were two or three sisters sitting on the couch together, you know, embracing each other, you know, taking in this conference together. And boy, did that make my heart smile. I mean, it was just a beautiful sight to behold. So thank you to each of our dynamic breakout speakers. Let's give them a hand. They were absolutely amazing. And we have, again, some amazing nuggets to take with us as we continue to press on through the struggle. One of the ladies said that we are all struggling with the struggle, and that's absolutely true. And then I also heard somebody say that God is up all night. And guess what that means? If God is up all night, we don't need to be up all night because he already has it. He already has it. You know, somebody said that deliverance is not an event. It's not an event. It's a lifestyle. So it is the way we should live, and knowing that God has us every step of the way. And then I also heard that sometimes you can live a sermon better than you can preach one. And what does that mean, ladies? That means let your life be a reflection. Let people see Christ in you. I don't know if you guys heard Mary Mary's song, "It's the God in Me." That is absolutely beautiful, because when people see you, they should see Christ. They should see his reflection in the life you live. So thank you all again. And as I talk about reflection, the next thing on our program is a song. It will be a moment for us to reflect on all that God has brought us through. Not just over the last 18 months in this pandemic and this struggle, but where God has brought us through our entire lives, how we're able to now live forward, but look back and reflect. Next up, a song.
Yeah.
Amen. Now, many of us on are members of Central Point, but for those who are not, if you've ever been to a service at Central Point Church of Christ, you know we have some amazing singers. Oh my goodness. And we praise God. And I just, oh my goodness, that just took me back. And I definitely felt it when she said, sing, Sierra. Yes, Lord. Yes. Ladies, I have had an amazing time sharing with you guys this Saturday. And I want to say thank you to each and every one of you all for joining us today. We have looked back. We have seen our videos from the beginning through the first 15 years. And we're going to see a video in just a moment that's going to take us through our present day. And then after we see that video, the next voice you will hear will be that of our amazing First Lady, Sister Shalonda Doolin. And I want you guys right now to, before we see the video and before she comes up after the video, just stop and give her a round of applause as well. Yes, I like that round, Sister Doolin. Yes, yes. Shalonda is absolutely amazing. And with all the hats she wears, she just so eloquently leads our women's ministry. And she brings not only her creativity, her time, her dedication, but she brings her whole heart to the table. And we can't thank you enough. You know, we can't thank you enough for everything. So next up, ladies, we have our video that will take us on our journey through the last 5 years through present day. And the next voice you will hear is Sister Shalonda Doolin. Thank you all again.
My testimony, everybody, how God favored me in spite of my enemies. And if God did it for me, he'll do the same thing for you. Don't worry about your haters. Your haters can't do nothing with you. Listen to these words.
Love is patient, caring. Love is kind.
Love is felt most.
Love is felt most when it's genuine.
I had my share of love abuse, manipulated, and its strength
misused.
And I can't help but to give God glory when I think about my story. Oh yeah, y'all. I got a story to tell. And I know, you favored
me.
Because my enemies, they did try, but they couldn't triumph over me. Yes, they did try, but it didn't work. I'm still here. I'm still alive. I'm still blessed. On my way to my destiny. Because the favor of God is on my life. Let me tell you about love.
Love
is patient.
Is patient, caring.
Love is kind.
Is kind.
Love is felt most
when it's genuine.
I had a whole lot of people in my life who abused my love. They manipulated it and took the strength of it and tried to misuse it.
Hey, everybody. Look, I had to make sure I was on mute because I was singing. Great times. 20 years. Whew, I was trying not to get emotional. I'm not going to get emotional, but I just want to thank everyone for participating and for being here and just being a part of this journey with us. When we did Strength During the Struggle, I think it's very fitting for the time that we're in right now. But when I thought about it, I wanted us, it's real easy to look back and say, I was really strong and I had strength during that part of the struggle. But the challenge that I want us to really strive for is I want you to recognize the strength that you have during the struggle. Sometimes we forget that. Recognize not only the strength that you have, but the strength, of course, that God has during the struggle. And so look at during the time of a pandemic, during the time of uncertainty, during the time of failed relationship, during the time of lost loved ones. So that's when our Christianity, all those things, again, that we sing about, that we pray about, that we love to hear, this is when it comes into play. This is when we have to really think about all those things that we talk about. So again, thank you for being a part of this journey with us. Of course, I have just so many thank yous. I have to make sure that I have them written down because I'll forget. But of course, it wouldn't be possible without all of your beautiful faces in your white shirts and your pajama pants. How many of y'all got on pajama pants? I know you got on pajama pants with these white shirts, but y'all look pretty. The top up looks pretty, so shout out to that. Of course, a special shout out to my mother in love, who we knew was gonna pour wisdom into all of us because that's just what she does. Just a little side note, y'all. She was kind of like, I don't know. So I had to get her grandson. You know, if the grandson asks or we get Rodney to smooth it over, she'll do it. So I had to push. But see, we would have missed that blessing. So y'all need to thank Roman. Y'all need to thank your pastor. So thank you, Mama, for always just being the source of wisdom that we can always look to and for always pouring into us. Shout out to our communications team, our Shepherd Horace Forte. Y'all don't understand, we would not have been here without him. We stressed him out. This was our first virtual. So as you see, we've had 20 years of in-person and I think we did pretty good. Y'all think we did pretty good? And that's just working together because I work with an amazing team of women that, I mean, you forget that you're in a meeting because we're just working together. The spirits are great. Collaboration is always good. So I love them. And those are the women that made it possible. Our graphics design and the program, the beautiful program that you've seen, that's Chanel Ferguson. So I want to thank her as well. All of our program participants and our breakout speakers who took the time out to, I'm sorry, y'all, I just started storming. But yeah, just all of our wonderful participants and those that did our breakout rooms. Thank you for that, because that was the first time for us as well for that. We wanted to be creative and make sure that it was fun. Make sure that we can keep your attention because we know a lot of people are on this for work throughout the week. So we wanted to make sure that we had some creative things in there. So thank you for participating in that. And then of course, I cannot forget my wonderful husband, the pastor of Central Point. He's amazing, as you all know. But I want to thank him because he supports us with whatever we want to do. And so I want to thank him and our leadership for making sure that that things work out for us as well. And then again, our committee. So y'all give a big round of applause to our committee. We had to put our heads together to make sure that everything worked out. You know, with technology, it does what it wants to do. So you can plan and prepare and you never know. So we thank God that he allowed us to be able to have this all worked out for you all today. We could spend this Saturday morning with each other. I think I have everyone. But yes, I hope that you all were encouraged and edified. And that you can take this for those of you who are at different congregations throughout the world. And I hope that you can take this back and share it, as Sister Kayla said. Thank you to our MC, of course. She always comes through. Thank you, Kayla. So yes, we definitely want to make sure that you share. I believe that this is recorded as well. So make sure that you share with your sisters throughout your congregations, your friends, especially those who don't know the Lord. This is hard times for everyone. It's just a lot of uncertainty, but God. And so that's why we wanted to put that reflection in there that we did with the song, because sometimes we can get so overwhelmed by the struggle that we forget just all the wonderful things that he's done, how he's proven to be who he is. And so sometimes we just need to sit back and say, well, you know what? You brought me through this. So I hope that today that's exactly what happened for all of you, that we can reflect. Yes, we've had some struggles, but God has been amazing to us and for us. And we again thank you for sharing this experience of 20 years with Central Point with us. Now I would like Crystal Woodard to come, and she's going to do our closing prayer.
Hi, everyone. I know I have one job, but I have to say this, that wow. Like, when something is going to be great, but then it even exceeds your expectation on top of that. Like, we could have, everything was great. Sister Doolin, you could have dropped the mic and we could have just cut off at that
point. Right.
But it was just amazing. I've been here 11 years and I've never heard Sister Doolin speak. So I'm full. My emotions are all over the place. It was great. And then we get in our breakout room. And then we get some more great, you know, just nuggets and great information. This was great. And ladies, if I could encourage you to do anything, the first 48 hours after you get some great information is the most important. So not only remember it and think about it, but put it all into action, because that's when it's most important, because our lives are busy. And after that, you kind of forget and you move on, but put it into action immediately, and let all of this information that we got just work through you right now. If you could just all bow your heads and let's pray together. Dear Heavenly Father, we come to you today to say, and I don't think it's enough, but say thank you. Hello. Thank you for the conference. Thank you for the ability to have this conference. Thank you for everybody that participated. This was great and has blessed our lives. Be with us as we go on through the rest of our days. May we shine through you. May you shine through us so that we could help others, and just be with us, the rest of the world, as we continue to go through the things that we're going through. Again, and say thank you. Thank you for all of our blessings. In Jesus' name, we pray. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, ladies, so much again for joining us. We hope you guys have been blessed. I know I have been thoroughly blessed. I have pages and pages of notes. And like Sister Woodard just said, please take this time and share it with somebody else. Don't keep that blessing to yourself. We know we are blessed to be a blessing to others. So share that information and continue to go forth and let God's reflection be seen in your lives. Have an amazing weekend, ladies. Thank you for joining us. Until next year, we will see you hopefully in person for our women's conference. And you guys have a blessed and happy day. Thank you again.
Great job. Thank everyone. Thank you. Everyone.
Mm-hmm. Thank you everyone for joining us.
Jackie and Shalana, great program you had.
Great job. Awesome. Yes. Good job, ladies. Thanks, ladies.
Can you be blessed?
Bye, ladies.
You're blessed.
Bye, everybody.
Y'all did a wonderful job. Bye, thank you all.
Great job, ladies.
We enjoyed all.
See y'all.
Bye, everyone.
Bye, Jackie. Beautiful. Can we have Thank you, Jackie. Thank you.
Thank you, Jackie.
Thank you, Jackie.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, everyone.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Well, I expected this to be from 10 to 12. It must have been from 8 to 10.
Yeah, 50 standard time.
Yeah.
Hi, Linda.
Hi, darling.
Linda K, Beverly, yes. Shelley.
Hi, she's Linda.
Yes. Hey,
Jenny. Hi, y'all.
Earlene, sister.
Hi, sweetie.
Hello, sister Gaskin.
Hey,
Earlene. Beautiful.
Hey.
Hey.
Hi.
Take care.
Hello, sister.
Y'all be blessed. Have a blessed rest of the week.
Blessings, everyone.
Hi, everyone.
Bye.
Bye.
I see you on the recording.
Bye.
I think this.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye, everyone.
Bye.
Bye.
Talk to you later, Jackie. I stand and love you.
Later.
Talk to you later, Doris. I'll give you a call.
Hi. Can we get the recording from today's Zoom? Hello.
And your other little short friend. Sorry.
Thank you.